Hey everyone, this is Johnnyonoes, and I'm playing Subnautica, the silent running update, and in this fifth episode, we are going to start working on some of the things that have been hampering us for the last four or five episodes. First things first, let me show you what I did to the base. All I did was remove the third tier there. Because of the fact that I put the hatch on this corner piece here, which is really nice, I think I just might add like a power generator like going this way. I don't need to have three levels. I'll be okay with two. Like I said, this can be our first base. It's really only going to be used for our main storage and crafting area. We're going to make some cool looking bases later on in some way cooler areas. But for this one, I think two layers will be great. Just one for crafting and water, as well as some other stuff. And on the top floor here, it's going to be all about storage. So let's talk about the things that we need to fix here. First thing is storage. Obviously, we have very little storage. We're having to, you know, drop stuff. We're having to move things around. It's really annoying. And you've been hearing me complain about it for the last four episodes. So I'm going to fix it so I can stop complaining about it. So we're going to have to get some lockers up on this second floor. Maybe a couple in here too, just for some general kind of swap space type stuff. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have to build a replicator, the first aid replicator, as well as the radio in here too. So that way it removes all the needs that we have for going back to the good old life pod, which I think we still have two of them. Do we still have two? No, the first one disappeared. It's gone. Thank God. All right. So yeah, I want to make sure that we don't have to go to the life pod ever again. The other thing we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to get more power because of the fact that the replicator, the water filtration, which I'll talk about later, is going to need a lot of power. So we're gonna need to put up about six, I would think, of these solar panels up here to at least get us started, and that way we can build the water filtration, we can build the alien containment, and all that good stuff, which will be for our next issue, which is to get food in a way that we can easily just pick it up and, you know, not have to hunt for it anymore. So yeah, those are all the different issues we're going to work out in this episode. What I am going to do, though, is every time I need to go pick up a bunch of resources, you're going to see this icon up here in the bottom right. You're also going to see some timestamps in the description that are going to give you links to parts of the video that allow you to skip it. So you're going to be a little bit surprised at the length of the video. Don't fret. You're going to hear some cool jazz and you're going to be able to skip it if you want to. But I'm going to actually video me getting all the resources that I'll be getting for this to kind of do a compromise. I don't really like having to skip everywhere, but at the same time, I don't want you guys to have to sit through, you know, over 10, 20 minutes of me collecting resources. So, talking about collecting resources, what I'm going to do first is I want to start building those lockers. So, I have enough titanium right here from the multi-purpose room that I removed to build three lockers. So, lockers take one glass and two titanium. So we have three lockers worth, so all we need now is we need to pick up six quartz as well. So let's pick that up right now. I'm not going to go into jazz mode just yet, because quartz is actually pretty plentiful here in the Safe Shallows. Once we get everything built up and ready to the point where I'm like, okay, I want, you know, four full lockers worth of titanium and quartz and all that good stuff before I even do anything, that's when I'll start throwing the jazz at you. All right, let's see. We are now at, I think we've got enough quartz. So let's go and hit the life pod, process all the glass, and then head back to our base. All right, so we're back at the base. Let's go ahead and start building out our lockers. Now, everyone has their own way of doing this, but the way I like to do it is I like to do kind of a grouping of five in each one of the sides of the multi-purpose room. And the way I do that is I put one right dab in the center, and then I put four on the edges like so. Here we go. So I put one in the center and two on each side. We put the other one over here. And this creates like a grouping of five. And when I get this fully loaded up, I'm going to start putting some labels on the top so it can kind of tell me exactly, you know, what is in which locker. And I'll have five on each side. And that seems to be enough for me in terms of storage space. And then I'll load up the Cyclops with as much like titanium and quartz as I need to make a, you know, a pretty good looking base. But huzzah, we now have storage. That has been an issue this whole time. And you're probably really tired of hearing me whine about it. So I'm going to start throwing the stuff that I don't really need on me right this second. I'm going to keep the scanner. I should keep the scanner on me just in case. You know, I might see some flowers I like. So now I'm going to go run back and go back to the... Yep, there's this fart. Oh, God. I think all we're going to see is gaseopod from this base. But I'm going to run back to the light pod, pick up all the stuff that we left there, and then come back and put it in our boxes, and we'll get started on the next thing, which is going to be the replicator, which is going to make it really easy for us to get stuff done. Ah, look how beautiful that looks. An empty storage container in our life pod. All right, so now that we got storage out of the way, I'm going to stop whining about it. I mean, we're going to work on it some more. There's going to be a lot of lockers we have to make. But for now, we've got all the wiggle room we need. So for storage, actually, I should have got my sea glide, but I'll get it later. But anyways, storage, we're good. So now what we need to work on are the three pieces of equipment we need, which is the fabricator, the first aid replicator, as well as the radio thing. So for that, we're going to need a pretty good amount of stuff. We're going to need we're going to need computer chips. We're going to need wiring kits. We're going to need tons of titanium. And for the first aid fabricator, we're going to need some creep vine for the fiber mesh. So we need two fiber mesh for that. So the only thing I need to collect right now is really, you know, some table coral, some titanium, the copper, and then the creep vine. Not that big of a deal, but let's go ahead and start jazz time. Find the life pod. Thank you. Let's see if we can go find some of those, one of those, like, big corals. Really gotta throw a beacon down on one of them. I'll have to keep looking for it. We'll find some nodes in here. I gotta keep any lead that I find too, just in case we start doing a lot of rods for the nuclear power plant. Ooh, myself in a little bind here. No sea glide to save me.
Oxygen.
I don't even have a bladder on me. Goodness. It's like amateur hour here. Two more copper. It's really the problem point until we can get over to the sea treader's path. Where there is copper unlimited. Unlimited amount of copper in the sea treader's path. Peeper with oh, there's multiple peepers with floaters on them. Nice. Interesting. I've seen that before. Require crash powder too. That would suck. Be too hard to get. There it is. I don't think there's a lot of those large corals here in this biome and this safe shallows biome. I'm so used to getting all my stuff from the beginning of the game near, like, kind of more to the northwest. I think it's northwest. Probably wrong. But more this way, more towards where our base is at, actually. It'd be nice to have the replicator over there. I think we have all the titanium we need. We just need two more copper, I think. That's all we're missing right now. There's one more. Yeah, I remember coming in here before. I thought it was one of those thermal vents. Yeah, I guess I haven't spent a lot of time in this particular safe shallows biome. Come on, give me a big coral. A big, fat coral. This could be our lucky day. Copper. Yay, copper. All right, let's see. We got everything. We got the four copper for the wire, we got plenty of titanium, we got two gold, we got the wiring kits, we got the table coral. Alright, let's see. Let's see if that's all we need. Totally missing my sea glide right now. Or my sea moth for that matter. But I can't be using energy when I can't recharge it. Gotta be frugal. This is nice to go for a swim every once in a while. Process the titanium, the copper wiring, and make the two CPUs. Should be it. Let me just double check. So I need 2 titanium. So for the fabricator, I need 2 titanium. Got it. I need a wiring kit. I need a CPU. Boom. Wiring kit for the communications relay. Boom. And titanium. Done. Fiber mesh times 2. Where we got that there. An extra computer chip as well as 5 titanium. We got everything. All right. Head back to base and get out of jazz time.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I love you guys that sit here for the resource collection. I'm gonna tell you special stories. No, I have no special stories. I'm boring. But I'll just mumble to you guys. If you guys would like to listen to jazz, I think you'd like to listen to me mumble about stuff too. Special messages just for you. I'm not wearing any pants right now. I'm only telling you guys. I'm not wearing any pants. Alright, let's get back to the base and then get out of jazz time. Alright everyone, we have collected everything that needs to be collected for all 3 of these things that we're gonna make.
Welcome aboard.
Let's see if I did it right. Alright, so let's see, we got a fabricator. Can we put it right here? Fabricator placements are always sketchy. Right there. I like it. Put that there. And then we need a communications relay. Can that go anywhere? Oh, you know what else has a hard time being placed is the medical kit fabricator. Oh, that looks good. I'm good with that. Let's see. There we go. That looks great. Normally it's like half hanging off of a frame or a rigging. It looks good now. Nice. Should get myself a... Oh, it takes a little bit of time. All right, then let's do the communications relay. Oh, perfect. I like it. Everything against the doorway. All right, so we're gonna... Can I get hurt from this? No, I guess not. All right, so we got all that stuff built. So the next set of stuff we need to build now is we need to build a bunch of solar panels. So I'm going to try to aim for 6. So solar panels are relatively easy. It's just quartz and It's just quartz and titanium. I have a hard time finding this. There we go. Solar. Oh, it's only 2 per. It used to be like 5 and 5 or something like that. Unless I'm really confused. So let's get 10 quartz and 10 titanium. 10 quartz and 10 titanium. That's easy to do. Back into jazz mode we go! I'm gonna get my sea glide this time. Still not wearing any pants, guys. Only you guys know about it. Not a lot of charge on that guy. Let's get a battery. There we go. Alright. We're a little bit hungry too, so let's eat this, drink that. We have a little bit more water left. Wow, we really have very little water left. I thought we had more. Let's see. No, we have 1 more bottle left. That's okay. We got a replicator now. We can go hunting one more time. Alright, so let's go get us some quartz. We need 10. And like 1 scrap and then an extra titanium. Some more lead. But this isn't too hard to find. Probably not run into any crash fish. Alright, we're up to 7 already. Yes. A little bit of scrap here. Another one right here. Okay, cool. We're good with titanium now. A little bit more quartz and we'll be good to go. There's so many better places to get this stuff. Like, I just want to go to the Blood Kelp Trench and just pick 20 quartz within sight of each other. Now let's get out of the, here we go, there's another one. Get out of the kelp forest because there's not a lot of quartz there. Not a lot of quartz there. Salt. But not a lot of quartz. One of those trays, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete. Yeah, I think that's, yeah, we're 10. 10 and 10. Boom. 10 back. Actually, we don't need to use any of... Okay, let's just use the replicator for the... This stuff. Titanium. Huzzah! Get a health kit yet? No. Alright. Alright, folks, we're back from jazz time. Let's go ahead and put these solar panels up here. That'll give us, 300 power? Is pretty okay. Come on, you can jump. I made it on top of one that was on the third story. Why can't I jump again? Alright, let's see. Just place it from here. Power. That works. This is gonna look terrible, but that's okay. Let's put these up, and then we'll have 300 power, or at least a maximum of 300 power. I love how these things look like they're floating. You can see, like, little power transmitter things coming off of it. Right? Get that on there! Get on there! Yes! Thank you! I love yelling at my solar panels. I don't get much time. I don't get much time with solar panels. I always hate not being able to craft during the nighttime. Come on. That's... this is not going to look pretty, guys. Not going to look pretty at all. Alright, get on there. Oh, is that it? That's it. That's six. Look how beautiful it is. It's so symmetrical. Beautiful. Oh, my goodness. Alright, so we should have 300 power now. Yay, 300 power. Okay, cool. So now the next thing we have to build is what? We need to start getting some more titanium, which a little bit. Probably make a thingy here. So let's, which way we want to build? Let's do it from the outside. That'll be a little bit easier. So I want to build sideways for the alien containment. But sorry, I'm talking to myself now. So let's build sideways for the alien containment, and then we're gonna build out for the moon pools. So it looks like we're just gonna need a great deal of titanium, as well as a little bit of quartz for a hatch. Actually, I'm sorry, we're gonna need a lot of quartz for the alien containment. So the water filtration is really easy; it's just two titanium. We can actually build that right now, but I don't want to sap all the power right off the bat. But for the alien containment, it's like six... Is it like six glass or something ridiculous like that? Let's see. Interior pieces. Alien containment. It's four glass and one titanium. So that means we have to get 16 quartz and two titanium, plus another two quartz and titanium for the hatch. So, let's go back into jazz time. I told you there'd be a lot of resource gathering. Let's do it. Okay. Back to getting quartz. Should be picking these guys up too. Let's do that. These signals away. I have to do something with those later for sure. Because I do not know where the life pods are in this game. Not like I know where the wrecks are. It's nice they tell you what number it is. Oh, that's just the gun. 4 and 17. Okay. Cool. Alright, let's get... What was it, 16? 18? Yeah. 18 quartz. Oh boy, this is going to be a long one, guys. One! I could just go to the Blood Kelp Trench. Yeah, I'll do that. Be super fast. 16 is like easy. Let's do that. 2,000 years later. Alright, I'm finally over at the Blood Kelp Trench. Took me forever. I'm almost dying of dehydration here, but let's get this quartz. about, was it 18? This is where you get quartz for sure. Hi, Warper. How are you, buddy? Oh man, we're gonna have to head back before we get this quartz.
30 seconds.
Just count how much we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Good, we have enough. Let's go back. And let's not die of dehydration. So I'll skip this travel. Just so that all you lovely folks watching me gather resources don't have to watch me travel 600 meters. Ooh. Take it. Could not have cut it anywhere closer.
Caution. Mild.
Oh my goodness. Alright, let's go hunt for some air bladders. There we go. Just get some water in us. My god, did I miss it? I did. That's funny. Alright, we're gonna get some air bladders and maybe some peepers. Need food badly. Now look at all of them here. Crazy. Make the still suit. This portion. That's not where my hatch is. There it is. Another signal. Click the buttons properly, Mr. Johnny. Process all this glass. Hopefully this shitbox has enough power. Around 8, 1, 2, oh, we got more than 8, that's good. 2, so we needed 4, and we have 1 for the hatch. That is actually a perfect amount. So we need 4, 4, and 1. All right, cool. So let's see. We're gonna get some more titanium, then I'll start blah blah blahing again. Heart right now to go into the crash zone for titanium, so the kelp force is gonna have to do, and it's just not doing it for us.
30 seconds.
How the sea glide disappears when you surface. Yep. We're just full by one. Let's get rid of one titanium. Yep. I'm actually going to turn off this guy. See the life pod anymore. We don't need it. Titanium here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 right there. And that should be plenty more for anything else. We need like a ladder and a hatch. Alright, cool. Let's get out of jazz mode then, shall we? Let's get rid of this lead too. Need it in my inventory. This too. Cool. Out of jazz mode we go. Alright, after about a half an hour of good old resource gathering, we're now ready to put together our alien containment facility. So let's go ahead and throw down some multi-purpose rooms here. We're going to keep a close eye on our... You're having problems with it. There you go. Keep a close eye on the hull of our base. We may have to go over and get some lithium at some point. And we're now at 5.3. All right. That should bring us down to like 3-something. Or 4. There we go. Cool. Alright. Head back inside. And let's go ahead and make the alien containments. So we're just going to put one on top of the other. 2 always seems to be enough for me. Like, I never need more than 2. But I have a plan for a crazy aquarium for later. I want to go from like the bottom of the... I want to go from the bottom of the Grand Reef and then go to the surface and just make a pillar of multi-purpose rooms and alien containments and see what happens when I put 2 of every egg inside of it. Just see what it looks like. Well, there we go. Okie doke. Here's the hatch. Let's see how much resources we have left. Oh, look at that. We cut it nice and close. Perfect. All right. So the next thing we have to go gather is we're going to have to go gather some creep vine, because that way we can grow our own creep vine here. We have 2 levels. And we need to go get some Reginalds. So going back into jazz time once again, and I think that'll be the last one for at least this episode, because this episode's going to be pretty long, like about maybe 45 minutes or so. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go get some creepvine seeds. I think at least 4 of them. So we'll grab those first, and we'll come back to the base. And yeah, we'll get into good old jazz time once again. 4. We got a biter after us. The question is, do I just hold these up? Yeah, I'll hold these. I don't need that many Reginalds. So let's go ahead and head on over to the grassy plateaus, bring the sea moth.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Our eyes open for any Reginalds. We need at least 2, but it'd be nice to get like 6 of them to start. Because those are the best bang for your buck in terms of food. And yeah, I know I can do whole planting fruit and stuff, but I'm lazy. Just do this once and I'm done. I saw some Reginalds earlier. Let's just keep on scouting for them. Oh, I could have sworn I saw one. The spades. We tend to hang out with spades a little bit. See if we can find some before the power on this sea moth runs out. Like, I know there's like a chance that certain fish spawn, but I think it's in little blocks of fish. Like, I swear I'm seeing them. I must just be hallucinating or something. It's funny that we have 2 titanium. Oh, there they are. I see ya. We have 2 titanium, which is exactly what we need for the water filtration. No! Eat my Reginald, bastard! I want to eat him! Come on! They're too slow! I just need to swim! Swim, Johnny, swim! Oh my god, really? I'm an expert at hunting these. Oh my god, just click furiously! Click furiously! Oh my god! Why can't I catch you? Oh my god, this is crazy! What is going on here? Finally! I can't believe that took so long. Alright, where's my sea moth? Got 1. Looks like... Oh no, that was a dead one. Reef packs aren't causing any performance issues anymore, which is nice. There's 2 more. I see 2 more. Aim slowly, Johnny. Aim. You play Counter-Strike at 1 point. You can aim. I don't know why I'm having such a hard time with them. Little baby one. Yeah, if I can't catch the big ones, there's no way I'm going to catch the small ones. Oh, gotta save it before he gets eaten. Oh my god. Oh, and then the game lags. Great. This is hilariously bad. Oh my god. They must have just made them really hard to catch because I've never had this type of problem. Why? Jesus! Okay, there's another one. Like I said, I'm aiming for 6 of them.
30 seconds.
This is pathetic. Gosh. What do I have, like 3? I have 4. So I need 2 more. 2 more Reginalds. Save from the outside world. There was one on my left, too. Oh! Come on, Johnny. Come on, Johnny. You can do it. You can do it, baby. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Oh! Just swim. Oh, seriously, I had that one. Yeah, they must have made these harder to catch. Or I'm just an idiot. What is going on? Where'd he go? He eluded me. Oh my god. Okay, there we go. 1 more. There he is. Our last one. Please be easy to catch. Oh, I still had that. There we go. All right, cool. Got the Reginalds. Let's head back home and get the filtration machine up and the Reginalds in their house, and then we'll be good to go. next episode's all going to be about power. That means lots of titanium and lots of magnetite. Not too hard to get. Where did I see a lot of magnetite? I think it was the jelly shroom caves, maybe. I'm sure I saw a bunch of it in there. Oh, head down there. I mean, you can get a ton of it from the mountain. I'm just really scared to do that with the sea moth right now. I have to build another power core too. It's not hard. With our in-house creep vine, that's going to be growing soon. Oh, we're going to need that too for all the lubricant that we're going to need. At least get six up. That way we have another 300 power, just in case, you know, the solar power runs out. And we'll probably need to go nuclear for when we put moon pools in. We always call them moon bases. What is it about this game? I can never remember anything. All right, so we're back. Out of jazz mode. All right, our fishing trip is over. We've got the creep vine and we've got the Reginalds. So let's go ahead and populate this bad boy with all our goodies. All right, so let's right click, switch container. I always eat them accidentally. There we go. And let's drop our Reginalds there. We right click to drop. Delicious Reginalds. All right, these guys are going to start procreating and create more Reginalds for us. I think it's going to hold like 12 of them, but I think it's more than that, but we'll see. But yeah, we're now at a point where we have all the tools necessary to completely negate the life pod. We have the fabricator, we have the communications relay, and I've been collecting all these different signals during good old jazz time. I'm going to kind of house them in here for now, but I'll probably have like a special area for them. What we're going to do is we're going to go and adventure after we get this base all situated and ready to go. We're going to go ahead and collect these, or go to each one of these life pods to make sure that we're not missing any of the data modules that are there. But yeah, this is my first attempt at trying to do the whole jazz time and, you know, that sort of thing. Please let me know what you think about it. If you would like me to break it up into smaller episodes, please let me know. Or if you just like me to just skip over all the resource collection altogether. I'd really love to hear what you guys think. But anyways, this is Johnnyonoes, and I'm playing Subnautica, the silent running update. Thanks so much for watching, folks. In the next episode, we're going to start working on probably thermal and nuclear power for this base. I think that's our next step, because 300 solar power... Actually, you know what? That reminds me. I'm going to throw down a water filtration machine, too. Let's do that. I think we put it in one of the corners. Let's see what we can do with that. We have interior pieces, water filtration. Yeah, you put it right in the corner, right here. That's perfect. This is gonna destroy the amount of power that's in this base in like minutes. But yeah, like I said, thanks so much for watching, folks. If you have any questions about this game or any of the other games that I support, please go and leave your questions in the comments below. All right, folks, I will see you all in the next episode. Thanks.